weapon may be formed, but it won't prosper. When the darkness falls, it won't prevail. 'Cause the God I serve knows only how to triumph. My God will never fail. Oh, my God will never fail. I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory.
My beloved brothers and sisters in the Lord, it's always a great delight to welcome you to our meditation every Sunday. Today be the third Sunday in the month of November and the 50th day of the month. It is our prayer that wherever you go this week, God of heaven, we go before you in the name of Jesus Christ. We are still celebrating the faithfulness of this God who blesses his own children beyond their imagination. We have looked at the foundation of whatever blessings a children of God enjoys. And of course, that by the time the blessings are so evident, there is nothing anybody can do. At times, even the enemies may want to be jealous. They want to be envious of what the Lord is doing. But if the Lord be for you, there is nothing that can work against you. But then I know when these blessings are so evident, the enemies will look for a way to block the blessings even from flowing into your life or the continuity of the enjoyment of that blessing. But I want to declare concerning you this particular week, by the reason of the word of God, the enemies will not be able to truncate the blessings of God in your life. Every attempt made by the enemy to block the blessings of God in your life will fail. How do I know this? In Numbers chapter 23 and verses 7 to 8 and 10. Now, when the blessings of God have become so evident upon the lives of the children of Israel, that sent even Balak, the king of Moab, even Jethro. It was Jethro of what the Lord has done. And then invited Balaam. And hear what he said. And he took up his oracle and said, Balak, the son of Moab, had brought me from Aram, from the mountains of the east. Come, curse Jacob for me, and come, denounce Israel. How shall I curse whom God has not cursed? And how shall I denounce whom the Lord has not denounced? And then verse 20 quickly says, behold, I have received a command to bless. He has blessed, and he cannot reverse it. What am I saying? My brothers, my sisters, it doesn't matter all the attempts made by the enemy. Probably because your children are succeeding, probably your work is succeeding, probably you are doing great exploits in your profession. And there are people who gather together to say it will not be well with you. I want to say it will be well with you. Whoever curses you will be cursed. Whoever blesses you will be blessed. And that is the promise of God for you. Why? Because you are hidden. Your blessings are hidden in the Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, as you go on in this new week, every of the 7 days will attract the blessings of God into your life. Yes, you will be well. Yes, you will have more than sufficient to feed on. There will be provisions for you. You will not die untimely. And I want to tell you, there will be no barrenness in your house. These are the blessings of God. Nothing can block them because you revel in the abundance of the foundation of God, who is Jesus Christ, the solid rock on which your faith stands. Therefore, as you go into this new week, go and prosper. Go and be blessed. And the blessings of the Almighty God will rest upon you. Have a wonderful week in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.